Hi and welcome back. In the last couple of videos, we've seen how we can build different Getresponse forms and use them to collect subscribers on our websites. So in this video, let's look at plain HTML. So if you don't know how to get here, you'll just come here into forms and then click on create forms. So let's come and click on plain HTML. And what plain HTML is, this is a place whereby you can build a simple form that will not have the styles such as the ones we saw in the different forms that you created. So if you want to create, for whatsoever reason, you want to create a simple form that doesn't have any styles or JavaScript, then you can just come here and build out your form. So you can see this one already has an email. You can even add name, you can add a name, and if you want name to be something different, you can change it there. Name, this is whereby maybe you want to use this form and style it yourself, or you want to use it with an API. So maybe you want to use it with an integration where you want to build your own form. You can add other elements if you want to. All this here, you can add this URL, and you see if you add anything, it gets added here and the code will also get generated here. So unlike the other forms, with this form, once you build it, you need to copy this, because if you leave this page, it will not be saved. So let's say I just copy this and I can put it here in my HTML so that we can see how it is. So I have created this div and I can add that code in here. So I can just call it, let me just call it naked form, because it doesn't have any CSS and it doesn't have any JavaScript. So if I go and view it in the browser, you'll see how it is. So if I scroll down here, you'll see this is how it is. It doesn't have any CSS and it doesn't have any JavaScript. So if I try to subscribe, it's going to go to Getresponse. So you can see this is one form you're not going to be using. If you really, really want subscribers, you're going to use any of these other options that you have up here. But if you know what you're doing, you can come down here, copy this code, and use it with the Getresponse API. So in the next video, we're going to go into integrations, form integrations, and the first one we are going to deal with is Facebook. We're going to see how we can integrate Getresponse with Facebook, and then we're going to add a form on our Facebook page, and then after that we're going to do something about WordPress as well, using a WordPress plugin. So I'm going to see you in the next video when we look at Getresponse form integrations.